Moments with Miss Paula presents Spindlewood, adapted from Autumn by Windown Press, 1983.
In a cottage at the edge of a village lived a little girl. All through the summer she played in the meadow with the sun fairies and the wind fairies. She watched the water fairies as they danced dreamily to the song of the stream, as it made its way merrily through the meadow and onto the wide world. When they were not too busy digging and looking after the flowers and the trees, the gnomes were the greatest fun to play with, for they loved to laugh and play friendly tricks with the little girl. Now one day, when the trees were changing their green leaves to golden, red and brown, the autumn wind blew through the wood and over the meadow, singing, "Mother Earth is calling, so children you must go to gather round your mother deep in the earth below." All the fairies stopped their dancing and playing when they heard the call, and they left the meadow. The gnomes also finished what they were doing and hurried off, for they knew that now there was other work for them to do deep in the earth. The little girl was sad when she found that all her fairy friends had gone away. As she sat wondering where they could be, a wind fairy flew by in a great hurry. "Wait," called the little girl, "where are you going?" But the only answer she heard was, "Mother Earth is calling." Then the wind fairy flew into the woods and on. The little girl tried to follow the wind fairy, but it was no use, the fairy was gone. As she came to the edge of the forest, the girl caught a glimpse of an old, old gnome hobbling along through the trees. He could not keep up with the other gnomes, but as he was so very old and wise, he knew that if he just kept going, he would find them deep in Mother Earth's cave. "Please wait," called the little girl. "Please tell me where I can find Mother Earth."
"Oh, my dear," answered the wise old gnome, "that will not be so easy for you. You must first find a lantern to guide you, for the way is dark. And if you go along the golden path, there you will see a spindlewood tree. Ask for one of its lanterns. You will also need a key to unlock the door to Mother Earth's kingdom. If you go along the winding path, you will find a maple tree. Ask it for its magic keys. And lastly, you must bring a gift to gladden the heart of Mother Earth. If you go along the prickly path, you'll come to a holly bush. Ask for some of its scarlet berries to make a necklace with." And when he had said all this, the wise old gnome hobbled away till he disappeared among the trees. The little girl went deeper into the wood, not knowing how she would find the golden path which would lead her to the spindlewood tree. Suddenly, there before her on the path, she saw a golden leaf. "Surely this must be the golden path," she cried joyfully. And it was. All along the path there shone a golden light, which grew stronger and brighter as the little girl ran along. Soon she came to a beautiful spindlewood tree covered with tiny lanterns, and she sang to it. "Spindlewood, spindlewood, will you lend me, pray, a little flaming lantern to guide me on my way? The fairy folk have vanished from the meadow and the glen, and I would fain go seeking till I find them once again. Lend me now a lantern that I may bear a light to find the hidden pathways in the darkness of the light."
The Spindlewood tree then gave the little girl a tiny lantern which shone brightly. Holding the lantern carefully, the girl thanked the tree and set off to find the winding path. She'd not gone very far when she heard the sound of tinkling music. As she walked on, the pathway began to wind more and more. First it twisted one way, then another, and at every turn the tinkling music became louder and clearer, until at last the little girl saw a beautiful maple tree with bunches of strange twisty keys hanging from its branches. She sang to the maple tree. Maple tree, throw me if you please. Throw me down a slender bunch of russet golden keys. I fear the gates of fairyland will all be shut so fast that nothing but your magic keys will ever take me past. I'll tie them to my girdle, and as I go along, my heart will find a comfort in the tinkle of their song. The maple tree threw a bunch of tinkling keys at the feet of the little girl. Thanking the tree, she picked up the keys and tied them carefully to the belt around her waist and went in search of the prickly path. It was getting darker in the wood as the trees grew closer and closer together. Soon the path was so narrow that the little girl could scarcely make her way. She felt branches and leaves prickling against her legs and her face. Knowing that this must surely be the prickly path which led to the holly bush, the brave little girl kept going. Just as she thought she could bear the prickles no longer, the path became wide, and there stood the most magnificent holly bush, covered with bright scarlet berries. She sang to the holly bush. Holly bush, help me in my task. A pocket full of berries is all that I do ask. A pocket full of berries to thread on golden strands. I would not go a-visiting with nothing in my hands. So fine will be the rosy chains, so gay, so glossy bright. They'll set the realms of fairyland all dancing with delight. Thereupon the holly bush shook itself, and many scarlet berries fell to the ground. Quickly the girl gathered them together and made a beautiful necklace. Thank you, dear holly bush, she said. Now I can go to Mother Earth and be with my fairy friends again. The little girl looked around and wondered where the doorway to Mother Earth's kingdom could be. Then, further along the path, she caught sight of the wise old gnome's pointed hat disappearing down a dark hole among the roots of a huge oak tree. Holding her little lantern, the girl climbed down the hole and found herself in a tunnel, at the end of which was a wooden door. Taking one of the twisty maple keys from her belt, she put it in the keyhole, where it fitted perfectly. It turned in the lock, and the door swung open. There inside was a wondrous cavern. From the ceiling hung many, many lanterns like her own, and in the light, the little girl could see smiling faces of all the fairies. Some of them had already curled up sleepily in the folds of Mother Earth's cloak, as she sat there with her arms outstretched to welcome the little girl. Shyly, the girl stepped forward, and Mother Earth lifted her up onto her warm lap. The little girl gave the necklace of scarlet berries and watched as Mother Earth, her eyes shining with joy, carefully put it on. "Thank you, dear child," said Mother Earth.
I have been waiting for you. The fairies have been telling me about you, and the wise old gnome said you would come.
May I stay here and sleep on your lap? Asked the little girl. She began to feel very sleepy.
Oh, no, my child. Your own dear mother and father will be calling you soon, and there's something I would like you to do for me.
Mother Earth reached into her deep pocket and brought out a tiny sack woven with golden and silver threads.
Here are some precious seeds, my child. Plant them in your garden, and when the shoots peep out of the earth, you will know that your fairy friends are on their way to play with you again.
The next moment, it seemed, the little girl could hear her mother's gentle voice calling.
Wake up, my little one. You'll get cold sleeping out here in the meadow.
The girl sat up and rubbed her eyes. There was something in her hand, and when she looked to see what it was, she saw the tiny sack woven with gold and silver threads, and she could feel the precious seeds lying safely inside.
Mummy, Mummy, I've been to see Mother Earth, said the little girl,
and her eyes were shining.